this morning, the Asian markets are a tad bit under pressure. I mean, they had a really good run yesterday. So some of them are just seeing some profit taking right now. The investors are also digesting the Fed minutes. The SGX Nifty is now at the lowest point. Our research team is here to give you the list of top 10 stocks as we head into trade this morning. Anuj, as always, let me begin with you. What's on your radar today?
You know, Sonia, with the caveat that today could be a slightly, you know, a worse day for the market, especially if, the first half after yesterday's big rally, I think the point I'm making, and these are not day calls, I'm just looking at stocks where there's sign of bottoming out and inherent business still remains quite okay. Like Welspun Corp, I think it's showing some signs of bottoming out. Yesterday there was decent delivery buying. It's a stock which is now halved from its highs. There's no overhang of promoter pledges. Similar is the case with Jindal Saw. Again, stock showing signs of bottoming out, low debt company, decent business, no overhang of promoter pledge. So, short point being, you know, if you are the one who wants to build portfolios, now is the time to look at some of these companies where stocks have corrected because the market's corrected. But they're, you know, at least they're not leveraged and there's a decent business strength which is visible.
Okay. Well, I guess public sector banks, especially Allahabad and Corporation, should have a good day. It was always expected that they would get enough capital to come out of prompt corrective action, but that money has come. So, Abhishek, the details.
Well, the largest capital is being given to Corporation and Allahabad Bank. So, Corporation Bank gets a capital of 9,086 crores. As per our calculation, the Tier 1 ratio could increase to 17% as compared to 9.1% earlier. The net NPA ratio is at 11.47%. The calculation that I have done is that if you take a 5.95% of net NPA, this capital level is sufficient to bring it out of PCA. Same for Allahabad Bank, the capital given is close to 6,900 crores. The Tier 1 ratio, as per our calculation, increases to 12.58% versus 7.15% earlier, and the net NPA is at 7.7%. Back to you.
Okay. Well, we will come back to you for the other details as well, but I guess in terms of movement, these stocks are more key.
All right. So, well, let's keep an eye out on some of these PSU banks, but L&T from the large caps is the big one on our radar today. Anisha is here to tell us more. Hi, Anisha. Morning.
Hi, Sonia. Good morning. Well, as you remember, last month, SEBI had rejected L&T's 9,000 crore buyback plan. And post this, the company had told us that they're looking at various options to kind of move forward this process. Now that we know that the company, instead of going to the NCLAT, has reached out to SEBI again to reconsider this buyback proposal because there was some confusion about using the standalone numbers versus the consolidated numbers. The company is hopeful that they will be able to go ahead with this buyback plan before the end of the year. That is August 2019 itself. So you might see some Felix sentiment positive for the stock today, but it is to be seen what SEBI really decides and whether they go ahead with this buyback plan or not. Back to you.
Okay, that's important. Maybe a minor Philip. After all, SEBI has to agree. It's only a request from L&T. Reema, the telecom subscriber data for January is out?
It's out for the month of December, and the key headline is that Reliance Jio and BSNL have added subscribers, while Bharti Airtel and Vodafone have lost subscribers. But bear in mind, both Bharti Airtel and Vodafone Idea have introduced a minimum recharge plan, as a result of which the company has been weeding out some of those subscribers who haven't been, you know, even making that bare minimum payment, which is why both the companies have been losing subscribers for the last 2 months. So for the month of December, Bharti has lost 15 lakh subscribers, Vodafone Idea about 23.5 lakh subscribers, BSNL, the market share is still low in high single digits, but that's added 5.5 lakh subscribers, while Jio has added more than 85 lakh subscribers. But it is on account of the fact that of the minimum recharge plan introduced by Bharti as well as Vodafone Idea that they've been losing subscribers.
All right. Well, of course, standard disclaimer, Reliance is the company. I mean, Reliance Jio is owned by Reliance, and Reliance also owns TV 18, Network 18, which run the channel that you're watching. Separately, there's news on Vodafone Idea, Reema.
Yes, because they held an analyst meet yesterday. Some of the key takeaways, one, they expect the cumulative EBITDA to be 20,000 crore rupees at the end of 8 quarters, that's the end of 2 years. This is much higher than the current EBITDA run rate, and this will be driven by network synergies, the minimum recharge voucher program that the company is currently undergoing, as well as the shift from 2G to 4G subscribers. On the debt issue, they believe that they're adequately funded for the next 2 years once that equity infusion of 25,000 crore kicks in, as well as the tower monetization, which will give the company an additional 5,000 crore rupees. One concern is that the revenue market market share of Vodafone Idea may be 36%, but the data volume market share is as low as 18%, as a result of which the company may end up losing market share, is what analysts believe. Back to you.
Okay, so losing market share this way and that. All right, keep an eye out on the stock. But let's move on to the pharmaceutical space. Glenmark and Sun Pharma on our radar today. Ekta has more. Hi, Ekta. Morning.
Morning. Some US approvals which have come through. So for Glenmark, it is a psoriasis drug. The market size of this particular drug is around $60 million. There will be around 2 to 3 players in the market for this particular drug. So small opportunity for Glenmark, but nonetheless positive. Sun Pharma has received an approval for a cancer drug, which is an injectable. So this could be a positive for Sun Pharma simply because most of their injectables are filed from the Halol plant. So this could be indicative of the fact that it could be an approval from there. And it's positive because approvals had slowed down despite the US FDA issues getting solved in that particular facility. So this should probably come as a positive.
Okay, that's good to hear. Sonal, some more stocks on your list?
Yes, good morning, Lata. Well, I'll start with DHFL. That stock will be in focus yet again today because there are unverified reports which suggest that the holding company, that is Vadhavan Capital, Global Capital, that is in talks with strategic investors to sell some controlling stake in the company. And the investors include the likes of KKR, Blackstone, Barring PE, Hero Group and Piramal Group. However, CNBC TV18 has not independently verified this report. Moving on, BPCL will also be in focus because the board says that they're planning to raise up to 2,000 crore rupees, that is via private placement of unsecured non-convertible debentures. So that stock should also react to this news today. Back to you.
All right, thanks for that. Here's a quick recap then of the top stocks in focus. Stocks with positive news flow today: Welspun Corp, Jindal Saw, Corporation Bank, Allahabad Bank, L&T, Reliance, DHFL, BPCL, Glenmark Pharma and Sun Pharma. While stocks with negative news flow this morning: Bharti Airtel and Vodafone Idea. Right, but let's talk about the other banks that could be in focus because of the recapitalization plan. Abhishek, you told us about Corporation Bank. What are the others?
Well, to keep out of PCA or taking a, you know, preemptive measure from the government, Andhra Bank is getting a capital of 3,256 crores. So that increases its Tier 1 ratio to about 10.6 versus 8.3. Remember that the net NPA was close to 7% at the end of Q3 FY19. Syndicate Bank is another bank which the government is intending to keep out of PCA. The capital given is 1,600 crores. So Tier 1 ratio increases to 10.6 versus 9.7 earlier. The net NPA is at 6.75%. Now, despite capitalization, some of the banks, may fall under PCA framework as the capital doesn't suffice to bring down their net NPA ratio to 6% or below. So first one is PNB getting a capital of 5,900 crores. Tier 1 ratio increases to 9.7 versus 8.3% earlier, and the net NPA ratio is at 8.22%. Union Bank of India is the other bank getting a capital of 4,112 crores. The Tier 1 ratio increases to 10.5 versus 9%, and the net NPA ratio is at 8.3%. So despite capitalization, some of the banks can still remain under PCA. So Central Bank of India getting a capital of 2,560 crores. Indian Overseas Bank, which is getting a capital of close to 3,800 crores. UCO Bank and United Bank each getting a capital of 3,300 plus and 2,800 crores, but will remain under PCA framework. Other banks which are already out of PCA but still getting capital is Bank of India, where the capital given is 4,640 crores, and Bank of Maharashtra, which is the lowest capitalized bank in terms of the capital from government yesterday, is at 205 crore of capital that they are getting.
Back just to a point, Bank of India should be advantaged because it's already out of PCA and this is a substantial amount of capital. As for Union PNB, I don't think this RBI is going to put any further banks in PCA. It required a Patel to do that, and I think you have to give it to that governor that he could extract capital from the government by moving the rules. I don't think any further bank will go into PCA now, not until the elections for sure.
Okay, well, let's do one thing. Let's take a quick break on that note. On the other side of the break, after the big move on the upside yesterday, is there more to go or should you take profits here? Ashwini Gujral, Sudarshan Sukhani and Mitesh Thakkar, our technical gurus, will be with us.